What's up, YouTube? Welcome to another episode of the Med School Forum. Now, in this episode, I'm going to do a quick book review of two medically related books. One of them's more of a kind of consumer, everyday kind of book. Anyone can read it and catch on pretty quick. And another one is really geared towards just medical students. So the first book, I'm sure every one of you has probably heard of it, and probably the majority of you have read it, and it's this book here, Complications, A Surgeon's Notes on an Imperfect Science by Atul Gawande. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Very famous author. He's a staff writer for The New Yorker, general surgeon. Really, really, really good writer. I mean, he writes in a way that even someone who really has minimal background in science and medicine can understand the cases that he describes in this book. And he's a really good writer, so it's an enjoyable read. Now, I'm sure that most of you, as I said, have actually heard of this, if not read this book. And the reason that I picked up Complications was that I kept hearing about how good of a book it was. So I was wondering, you know, what's it about? So let me give you the quick rundown. It is a collection of stories. It's not like a major kind of novel where it's like you're following through like different scenes. It's a collection of different stories while he's in residency. If you're a little bit older and you actually read his writings in the New Yorker, you will realize that a lot of them are actually in here. But nonetheless, it's a really enjoyable read. As I said earlier, it's not designed just for medical students or people in medicine. It's designed for the broad spectrum of anyone who wants to read it, who's interested in medicine. And so what the book actually does is that he goes through different patients that he's seen and talks you through the difficulties of maybe diagnosis, the difficulties involved in having the physician-patient relationship, the difficulties he had within himself or with a patient or with a family, or just with actually being a resident. So it's a real nice insight into what general surgery residency is like. But it's also nice just to get an insight into what it's like to be a young physician or to be a young surgeon or to just be learning medicine in the U.S. He really covers a broad spectrum of topics in a real beautiful way. So I would highly recommend this book to read, not for gaining like, you know, textbook skills or anything, but you're just going to get a better appreciation of what is medicine, how is it taught here, and what things should we be looking out for that are, you know, inherent fallacies in how medicine is taught. And it's a really enjoyable read to just enjoy a good series of stories that are in medicine. So I would highly recommend it. I'm really glad that I read it. It's a really quick read, which is a nice shocking surprise, because even though it's, I don't know, it's like about 260 something pages, it goes by very quick because of how easy it is to read and enjoyable. I mean, it's the definition of a page turner as far as I'm concerned. So once again, here's the book, Complications by Atul Gawande. Highly recommended. Out of 5 stars, I'm giving it a full 5. Awesome book. Alright, so this other book is geared just towards medical students. I don't know why anyone else would want to read it. And it's classic. Isersen's Guide, Getting into Residency, A Guide for Medical Students. And this is the 7th edition, which is the latest one from what I could tell. This book is as thick as the Bible. I mean, it is a really dense but awesome book. I mean, you want to talk about an excellent text. This is it. And I know some of you are wondering, this kid's a week into medical school. What's he doing buying a book for residency? Well, that's the beauty of this book. There are other books out there made by like First Aid or Kaplan that talk about match day or tips on getting into like the residency of your choice or tips on like residency interviews that are really for down the line when you're a fourth or third year. This book contains a lot of that information, but it also contains things that it believes you should start early in your medical school training. And I'll just cover, I mean, I didn't read all of this. I read all of Complications really quick. Being a first year, you can go through the table of contents and just kind of pick out what you need to read and what's relevant to you now. I mean, for me, it made no sense to read interview tips for residencies or how to pick a residency, but it was important for me to read various topics. Let me just go through the through the table of contents here. So this book, as I told you, is very thick. over 600 pages, but you know, it really is just full of gold as far as I'm concerned. So it's really nice because it gives you an overview of what's it like to apply to residency and what's the problem. And the problem that he keeps describing is overabundance of applicants and limited number of spaces. And he has some really nice graphs that he gets from various official sources. He actually goes through each and every specialty, at least the major ones, in about 80 pages of going through each specialty, telling you what it's like, telling you what kind of, I guess, discriminating components residency directors use to pick their applicants, AOA-approved programs, what was the rank in school, if they did any research, etc. But more importantly than in those details, which are kind of, you know, changing all the time in a lot of publications, it gives you a nice rundown of what each specialty is. For those of you who are medical students, you'll know that you can go to Careers in Medicine and log in with that ID you have from your school, and you get the same information for free. But if you're not a medical student and you want that information, here it is. But it's just nice to read it here because it's already in the book. Okay, so here's where it gets good. Choosing a specialty, and it gives you kind of insight at an earlier age. And here in chapter 6 and 7, which I found to be the most important, was starting the process. And it finds very important to be picking a mentor or an advisor early in your medical career. And that I thought was a brilliant idea. I happened to do that in undergrad. Unknowingly I did it, and it helped me out later. What Eisersten is saying is pick a mentor early in medical school so you can get to know over time, build a relationship with, and the benefit of that being that as you progress through your medical years, you have someone to go to if you have challenging questions, you want to know where you should be in the progress, if you want help into getting some kind of into a research program or into some shadowing or some clinical work, you have someone who has your back, who is fighting in your corner. So that in and of itself is a really big component that he devotes half a chapter to. And the other half is, I forgot it already. And the other half was choosing your specialty of choice, which he kind of talked about. Not relying solely on your third year experiences during clinical rotations, because that can be contingent upon how your attending was, how the team was, and that can adversely affect your decision. So you may love your clinical rotation in a certain specialty, but get into residency and dislike it, or vice versa. So he really makes a big push to say don't rely on your clinical third year for all of your experience. Early on, get out there and start shadowing, get out there and start just kind of getting involved in the clinic to get a feel for maybe what you're interested in. Not necessarily picking a specialty, but just realizing what are my characteristics and traits and in which specialties do I see them. So again, great book. I actually found this book highly recommended by most medical students. It was recommended to me by a third year. Obviously, that third year was reading it for reasons because they're getting close to the residency application process. But nonetheless, it was recommended to me as a first year because it contains content just so you can start planning your career effectively in your medical school training. And when it comes time to third and fourth year, you've already been thinking about it, you have some information, and you're not caught by surprise, and you have a more enjoyable experience. And hopefully the goal of reading this mammoth of a book is to have reached a point in your third or fourth year where you're thinking about a specialty, applying to the program, and hopefully upon graduation, you match into something and you know it's right for you. That's the goal of probably every medical student, so hopefully if you start off early on this book, it'll help you. So, book for fun, book for helping you out in the future, both I find to be great. So that's my book reviews. These are two books I had a chance to look at recently. Let me know what you guys think, and if you have any other book recommendations that you've read, either for fun with like complications or for benefits like Eisersten's getting into residency, let me know in the description below. And hope to see you guys later with another video, and as always, enjoy your studies.